In this video, you'll see how to add custom post-launch actions in AWS Application Migration Service, or MGN. Using the post-migration modernization feature of MGN, you can enable post-launch actions for migrated source servers and add custom actions to the post-launch settings. Following that, you can launch test instances to confirm that custom actions execute successfully, as well as launch production cutover instances. We'll start from the AWS Application Migration Service page. Let's go to Settings and create a post-launch template. To use this template, we must first enable post-launch actions. This will allow MGN to install the AWS Systems Manager agent on newly launched servers and execute the actions we specify. Next, we can choose a deployment option. Let's retain the recommended option, which is to deploy on both test and cutover instances. The template includes several predefined modernization actions that can be enabled. We're focused on custom actions, so let's save the template and move on. Now that our template is saved, we can add custom actions to it. Let's give our custom action a name. Next, we'll select the Systems Manager or SSM document we want to execute. For this example, we'll use the AWS Run Patch Baseline document, which performs patching operations on managed instances. SSM documents can have multiple versions. We'll choose Default Version at Runtime. We can specify the order in which our custom action is executed. For custom actions, the order number begins with 1001. Next, we'll select the source server operating system that our custom action is targeting. The box labeled Activate This Custom Action must be selected for the action to execute. Action parameters are derived from the SSM document that's selected. In this case, we'll select Install for the operation parameter because we want patches that are missing from the baseline server instance to be installed when MGM runs the SSM document. We'll leave the other parameters as the default. You can learn more about the different action parameters of Systems Manager documents in the links for this video. Let's add the action. Our custom action is now listed in the post-launch template. The template will only be applied to newly added source servers. We can also edit post-launch settings on existing source servers. Let's navigate to the Source Servers page. Let's look at the post-launch settings for the oldest server. These settings do not include the custom action we configured, because this server was launched from the template before we made our changes. We could add the custom action directly to this server settings if we wanted to. Let's look at the newer source server, which has the AWS SSM agent installed on it. As expected, our custom action has been configured. Now, let's launch a test instance to execute the post-launch actions for this server. From the Migration Dashboard tab, we can track the lifecycle of the source server and monitor the status of the replication and post-launch actions. Here, we can see the high-level execution status and confirm that the post-launch actions have succeeded. If we want to drill down into additional details about the execution, we can select our Patch Post-Launch action, which will open in the AWS Systems Manager console. We can select the target instance to see the output. Command output is provided for each step of the Systems Manager document we specified in our custom action. Each action in MGN is based on an SSM document that can be executed on any EC2 instance running in AWS. Using MGN, you can create custom actions based on public SSM documents provided by AWS, or on SSM documents you have created. You've just seen how to add custom post-launch actions in AWS Application Migration Service. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.